together.
Honey, I am so fresh out of time. Judge Carlovati's upstairs right now putting on his robes. He's heading into the courtroom, and when court convenes, he's going to make me close the case.
What if RJ turns out to be the killer?
Do you think it'd come down to that? I can't imagine RJ to picking up a 38 and... Bo, you gotta let me in to see him. Can you swing that?
Wait!
You gotta relax. It's not the way to...
Kevin.
Ready?
As I'll ever be.
Honey, I gotta talk to you for a minute.
What's going on?
She'll be right back.
Nora.
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
What's going on? You got something. What is it?
I can't go into it right now. Not the details. I gotta go. But you gotta go in there and stall, honey.
Stall?
Yeah.
Stall? How do you expect me to stall? I'm going in there and giving my summation
right now. Right now you gotta stall and keep on stalling until I get back.
How?
You are the legal wizard. You're gonna think of something.
Does Mrs. Buchanan realize she's holding up this entire trial?
Your Honor, I'm sorry. She's right outside, and I'm certain she's on her way in.
Bailiff, would you make sure she doesn't get lost?
Dale, what's going on? Is no one trying to tick off the judge?
Bo needs to talk to her. I'm assuming it's important.
Well, does Bo have something?
I don't know. I'm sorry, Antonio. I wish I could tell you something.
What do you mean you want me to stall?
Yeah, drag things out. Just don't start your summation until I get back.
Well, how much time will you need? I'm planning on talking for about an hour. Where exactly are you going?
Boston.
Boston? Are you kidding me? That wouldn't be a summation. It'd be a filibuster.
Call it whatever you want, honey. You just have to keep going. Don't let this trial end until I get back.
Mrs. Buchanan?
Yes, thank you, bailiff. I'll be right there.
Can you at least tell me why you're coming?
I don't have time. You wouldn't believe me if I did tell you. I'll get back as fast as I can, okay? I love you.
Andy, I didn't see you sitting there. How's it going?
Alex, actually, it's not too good.
Mrs. Buchanan, nice of you to join us.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Are you ready to begin your closing argument?
Your Honor, may we approach? Your Honor, I hate to do this, but...
Do what?
I need to ask for a recess.
Oh, I don't think so, Your Honor.
There's a problem, Mrs. Buchanan.
Your Honor, some new information has come to light that could have a major impact on this case, I think.
And that information would be?
Well, I don't exactly have all the details nailed down yet.
So you're asking us to go on another one of your wild goose chases. Remember that mystery witness that you had to call before you could rest your case? The witness that never materialized?
This time, that won't happen.
I know, because I won't let it happen. The district attorney has already given his summation, and now it's time for yours, or your request for a recess is denied. Either you give your closing argument now, or we'll skip it, and I'll start giving my instruction to the jury. Mrs. Buchanan, sometime in this century, please.
Yes, Your Honor. I seem to be missing just this one little piece of paper.
Nora, what's going on?
Bo, he's found the lead. He wants me to stall until he gets back, so I'm sitting here treading water. If I start to go under, Taya, you have to do something.
Like what?
Mrs. Buchanan, enough.
Yes, here it is. Thank you. Very sorry. Oh, dear. Okay. Well, no, it's okay. I got it. They're all in a particular order. That's all. Thank you. I'm sorry. Your Honor. Just be a minute. Got it. I'm very sorry, Your Honor. I really am. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Apologize to the jury. They're the ones you're holding up.
Yes. They're all here. Sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, the judge is right. This has been a very long and tiring trial, and I want to thank you for your attention and your patience. I'm sure there are times you wish this all could go a lot faster, but I also know you want to do the most responsible job that you can, because after all, the stakes are very high. I mean, a man's future, his whole life, is in your hands. And you have to know who this man, Antonio Vega, is. And that takes time, because he's a living, breathing human being. And he has a past.
But he kind.
Good call.
Good call. Last scene from Terms of Endearment.
Counselor, are you going to be okay?
I think I'll live. But you know, I need to clear my throat and it can get pretty ugly, so I better go ahead.
Yeah, well, you do need some more of that clown. Oh, don't forget the beast.
What are you...
Nora, I know you. And you are certainly putting on the performance of a lifetime. Now, if I were the judge, I wouldn't buy one bit of it. Not asking, I will. What are you up to?
Your Honor, yes, I am, and thank you so much for your concern. I appreciate that very much. I'm sorry, these coughing fits, they just, you know, come and go. They're very mysterious. I've had them for years, you know. I have. I always thought they were due from stress, but when I went to the doctor, you know, he thought they were from mold spores. Mold spores. I mean, whoever thought of mold spores? I mean, who can see a mold spore? You can't see a mold spore. I don't have any in my house, of course. I mean, my house is very clean. I don't have any coughing attacks in my house. I haven't found. Because I kind of keep it very clean. But when you walk into these musty old buildings, these courtrooms, I mean, mold spores everywhere. Hello? I mean, who can see them? I mean, we used to spend hours in here just sort of cleaning up. There's one. There goes one. Unless I came in with my own bottle of disinfectant. I mean, I guess I just have to learn to
Mrs.
live with
them. Buchanan, yes. Brace yourself.
Yes, sir.
Take a cough drop. But please... Please, would you close out your closing argument?
Yes, sir. Yes. And I would like to thank the jury for your forbearance. Courtrooms and everything that happens in them, I'm sure, seem very foolish to all of you. You know, or maybe even worse than that. But I'm sure you've heard the expression, crazy like a fox. My father, who was a judge himself, was very fond of that expression. Because he felt that it reflected all the contradictions of the law, where ordinary people are asked to produce a very extraordinary thing, justice, which is greater than all of us, and wiser, which reminds me of one of my father's favorite stories, not a courtroom anecdote, of which he had many of those. No, this is an old Jewish folktale. It's called The Daughter Who Was Wiser Than Her Father. And it's about a young king who decided he must marry the wisest woman in the kingdom. She could be high-born and low-born, it didn't matter to him. Of course, this made his advisors plot, but, you know, he didn't listen to them, as usual. So he took off his crown, and he took off his robe, and he put on the simple clothes of a commoner. And that's when the young, wise woman explained to her angry father that the king in disguise was not the simple idiot that he appeared to be, that he had given her father the head of the chicken because he was, after all, the head of the family.
Counsel,
yes,
would you approach?
Yes. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Now, Mrs. Buchanan, have you taken leave of your senses? This is a trial. Not a folklore seminar or the history of Latinos in North America. If you don't come to the point, and soon...
Your Honor, if I was rambling, that was not my intention. It's just, you know, I've always felt that this case was so very sketchy, and I kind of wanted to fill it in with a little background information.
Well, you've come up with a Picasso. And believe me, the jury is bewildered because I know I am. You're wasting our time, deliberately, and you're damaging your client's case. And if you continue, I'm going to hold you in contempt of court.
What do you mean? Why am I worried? Have you ever seen Nora fumble around?
Here, run.
Something up her sleeve?
That's it. My bag of tricks is empty.
Good. Because if you stall any more...